In this tutorial, inshallah, we will solve questions about steady devices. Okay, mainly about steady devices that contains only one inlet and one outlet. Okay, there is only one inlet and one outlet. Okay, so the mass flow rate m dot one will equal to m dot two, and in general, it will equal to m dot. Okay, so that is the conservation of mass. So in nozzle, diffuser, compressor, turbine, and throttling valve, these devices that we will solve on in this tutorial, inshallah, always we will have that the mass flow rate m dot one equal to m dot two, and in general, it is m dot. Okay. Mainly in this tutorial, we'll use two equations. Okay, that m dot is equal to rho times the volume flow rate. Okay, like we know that the mass is equal to rho times the volume. The mass flow rate is also equal to rho times the volume flow rate. And rho, the density, is the one over the specific volume. Okay, so we will write it like this: the volume flow rate over the specific volume. We already familiar with this equation. Okay, and the volume flow rate is the multiplication of the area times the velocity. Okay, so we will replace the volume flow rate by the area times the velocity. This one is velocity, okay, not volume, over the specific volume. Okay, we will use this equation in most of the questions, okay, if not all the questions. And we will have other equation, which is E dot in equal to E dot out. Okay, the energy balance for steady devices. We don't have change in the state of the system or in the energy of the system, so delta E is zero, so E dot in will equal to E dot out. And usually, if he asks about the area, of course you will use this equation because it is the only equation that contains area. If he asks about velocity, maybe you will find it from this equation or this equation. If he asks about the specific volume, of course from this equation. If he asks about the pressure, maybe you have air or gas in the question, then you will find the specific volume from this equation. Then you will use the equation BV equal to RT to find the pressure. So in general, we have limited equations. So usually we'll use these two equations. So let's start solving with the first problem, 538. We have steam, okay? Steam means table A4 to A6, A4 to A6. At 4 megapascal and 400 degrees Celsius, enter a nozzle. We have a nozzle. The nozzle, we draw it like this, okay? You have a decrease in area, okay? So this area is a lot larger, and it will be decreased until the outlet of the nozzle. And the purpose of the nozzle, or to use the nozzle, is to increase the velocity. So you will see that the velocity here is 60 meters per second, he will mention, 60 meters per second. So V1 is equal to 60 meters per second. And he will ask you about V2 in the question, okay? And you'll find there is a huge difference between the values of V1 and V2. So let's continue the question. He said 4 megapascal and 400 degrees Celsius enters the nozzle. So we have B1 is equal to 4 megapascal, okay? And it is equal to 4,000 kilopascal. Maybe we'll use it in kilopascal in the table because we have steam. And T1 is equal to 400 degrees Celsius, okay? Steadily, and even if he didn't say steadily, we know that the nozzle is a steady device, okay? So there is no change with time, with a velocity of 60 meters per second, so V1 is equal to 60 meters per second. And it leaves at 2 megapascal, so B2 is equal to 2 megapascal. And T2 is 300 degrees Celsius. Okay, the inlet area of the nozzle, he gave you the inlet area, so A1, okay, for the inlet, is equal to 50, and we usually deal with meter squared, so we will multiply by 10 to the power negative 4. In order to convert from centimeter squared to meter squared, you will multiply by negative 10 to the power negative 4, okay, meter squared. And heat is being lost, so heat is out from the nozzle, so I have Q, okay, and he said rate means power, so it is Q dot, okay, Q dot out is equal to 75 kilojoule per second, okay? In part A, he asked to determine the mass flow rate, A, m dot, and we know that m dot 1 equal to m dot 2, and it is equal to m dot in general, so he is asking about m dot, okay? And also he asked about the exit velocity, so V2 at part B, V2, And the final requirement is the exit area of the nozzle. So in part C, A2, okay? Now for the mass flow rate, we say that we have two equations, okay? Either I use this equation or the energy balance, okay? Let's see the first equation. I have, of course, when you said m dot 1 equal to m dot 2 equal to m dot, so that means that I can use this equation with the subscript 1 or 2. Yani I can say m dot equal to A1 V1 over V1, and it is equal to A2 V2 over A2 over V2. Okay, of course, I cannot use this with subscript 2 because already in the part B and C, I need to calculate V2 and A2. So I don't have this one and I don't have this one. So let's see if I can use this one. I already have the velocity 60 meters per second given in the question. Okay, and I have also the area 50 times 10 to the power negative 4 meters squared. Okay, the remaining is the specific volume. Okay, we have steam. So in order to get the specific volume, I need to use the table, okay? And I already have two properties in the table, which is the pressure P1 and T1, okay? So I can use the pressure and T1, okay, P1 and T1, okay? In order, P1 is equal to 4,000 kilopascal or 4 megapascal, and T1 is 400 degrees Celsius, okay? And then I can find what V1, okay? And then after I find V1 from the table, I can use this equation and calculate mass flow rate, and I'm done with part A, okay? What about part B, the velocity at the exit, V2, okay, V2. Also, I cannot use this equation because I don't have A2, it is still, I need to calculate A2 from part C. So this means that what is left for me is to use the energy balance equation, E dot N equal to E dot out, okay? E dot N equal to E dot out, okay, usually in this chapter, okay, we have a mass flow rate, okay? This mass flow rate contains energy, internal energy, okay? This internal energy, it is not, the mass flow rate means it is moving, okay? So it is moving because of a reason or because of a work. This work is called the flow energy, which is B times the specific volume. The internal energy contained inside the steam, and it is moved because of the flow energy. There is a pressure that pushes the steam to move, and it is applied on a specific volume of this steam, okay? This will move the internal energy, and this whole term, we represent it as H, the enthalpy, okay? This enthalpy is multiplied by the mass flow rate. So always in this chapter, you will have enthalpy in the equation or the energy balance. Of course, if you have velocities, so he's talking about kinetic energy, so it will be m dot V1 squared over 2. And in the exit will be m dot V2 squared over 2, okay? If you have elevations, if you have potential energy, it will be m dot GZ, okay, Z or H, okay? But we use Z because H is for enthalpy, okay? So usually you will have enthalpy in the energy balance, okay? So I have m dot 1, h1, okay? And here I also have velocities, okay? So also I will have kinetic energy, m dot v1 squared over 2. I don't have elevations. He didn't mention about z, so there is no potential energy. He is neglecting the potential energy, okay? Do I have work in or work out? Here in the nozzle and diffuser, we don't have any work in or work out, okay? And also in throttling valve, we will see we will not have any work in or work out, okay? Only we'll have the kinetic energy, enthalpy, and maybe he will mention heat transfer, okay? As this question, okay? We don't have anything in except these two, okay? So at the outlet, we have Q dot out, okay? He said heat lost. And also, of course, we will have m dot h2. And you already asked about the velocity, of course, Yani, we'll have m dot v1 squared over 2. And of course, I cannot neglect this velocity because we said that the velocity in the nozzle at the outlet would be much higher than the velocity at the inlet, okay? So if I already, put v1, of course, I will put v2. Maybe in the question, in the nozzle, he will assume, for example, he will give you V2 and said, let's assume that V1 is very less than V2, then you can assume V1 equal to 0. But I didn't find a question like this. Okay, and in the diffuser will be the opposite. We will see another question about diffuser. It will be the opposite. V2 will be less, will be higher than V1. Okay, but now we have nozzle, V2 is higher than V1. Okay, so that is the energy balance. Okay, what I need to find is V2. So this one is V2, okay? So I need to find this one, okay? I have the mass flow rate. I will be, I will calculate it from part A, okay? So I have all the mass flow rates. I have Q out. I have V1 given in the question. The remaining is to calculate H1. I don't have H1 and I don't have H2, okay? As I said, we will calculate V1 from B1 and T1, then put it in the equation for mass flow rate, calculate my mass flow rate. I can also use the pressure B1 and T1 to calculate H1, okay? From the table. Okay, the remaining is H2. H2, I have also two information at H2, which is B2 and T2. So I need also to use B2 equal to 2 megapascal and T2 300 degrees Celsius, okay, in order to find H2. Then I will already I will find everything, and the remaining is to calculate V2, and I finish part B. Now we're just talking in general, then we will put the numbers and solve, okay? The remaining is to calculate A2. We said that the only equation that we have that contains A2 is this equation, okay? And now I already found what already found V2 from part B, okay? And the remaining is I don't have V2, the specific volume at state 2, but already I have the pressure and temperature, okay, B2 and T2, so I can also find with the enthalpy V2, okay? I solved the question all the parts directly because we need two properties at H2 and V2, and we need also V1 and H1, okay? So it's to be clear for all the parts what we need to take from the tables to take it one time, okay? So let's solve. Okay, now first part is to solve for the mass flow rate, okay? And we said we will use V1, A1 over V1, and we said we need to calculate V1 from the table, so let's go to the table. Okay, at pressure B1 for 4,000 kilopascal, okay, and 400 degrees Celsius. Okay, at 4,000 kilopascal, I will go to table A5, the pressure table, okay, and I will compare my temperature with the saturation temperature. My temperature is 400 degrees Celsius, means it is higher than the saturation temperature, okay, 400 is higher than 250, means it is a superheated state. State 1 is superheated state, so I need to go to table A6, okay. I go to table A6, 4,000 kilopascal means 4 megapascal, okay? So at 4 megapascal here, okay? And at 400 degrees Celsius, I will take the value for V, specific volume, V1, okay? So you will have that V1 from the table will equal to 0.07343 meter cubed per kilogram, okay? And you have the area given in the question and the velocity. Class, let's calculate. V1 is 60 meters per second, and A1 is equal to 50 times 10 to the power negative 4. And V1 is 0.07343. So the mass flow rate will equal to 4.0855 kilograms per second. I already sent the solution for this these questions in the WhatsApp. I will send it also in Teams, inshallah, after the tutorial. Okay, so we found part A. Let's calculate for part B. For part B, he asked for the velocity, and we said we don't we cannot calculate the velocity from the equation that mass rate equal to A2 V2 over V2 because I don't have A2 and V2. So I will use the energy balance equation. Okay. The energy balance equation, as you can see, all the terms contains m dot, okay? So I can take m dot, any term that contains m dot on one side, and I will leave the q dot out on the right side, okay? So I will do this, and it will be m dot h1 minus h2 plus v1 squared minus v2 squared over 2, okay? And this will equal to q dot out, okay? And we said that I need to calculate H1 and need to calculate H2 in order to calculate V2, okay? From the table, we found V1. Also, I will use H1, this value for H1, 3,214.5. So I have H1. So H1 is equal to 3,214.5, okay? Okay, and also I need H2 from state B2 equal 2 megapascal and T2 300 degrees Celsius. Also, 2 megapascal means it is 2000 kilopascal, okay, because I want to check my temperature, compare it with the saturation temperature from table A5. So I will go to table A5 at 2000 kilopascal here, okay? And compare my temperature with the saturation temperature. My temperature is 300, so it is also higher than the saturation temperature. So I will go to table A6, the superheated table, at 2 megapascal, okay? So 2 megapascal is here, and 300 degrees Celsius is this value. Okay, so I need to calculate H2. So H2 is 3024.2, and we know that we will also take V2 in part C. But now let's write H2, the value for H2. H2 is also equal to 3024.2 kilojoule per kilogram. And this one also is in kilojoule per kilogram. Okay, so I have all the enthalpies. I have mass flow rate from part A. I have V1 given, V2, I need to calculate V2. And Q dot out is already given, but here, there is a problem that this one, enthalpies, are the units for enthalpy is kilojoule per kilogram. The unit for, and it is multiplied by the mass flow rate at the end, it will be kilogram per second, the mass flow rate, kilogram with kilogram will cancel, and the remaining will be kilojoule per second. Here also in Q dot out, he gave it to you in kilojoule per second, okay? But here the velocity, we know the unit for the velocity is meter per second, okay? And if we squared the velocity, V1 squared or V2 squared, it will be meter squared over second squared, okay? And meter squared over second squared, and we will multiply the velocities with the mass flow rate. So I will multiply by kilogram per second. Okay, so at the end, I will not have kilojoule per second. So I need to use a conversion factor. The conversion factor from meter squared per second to kilojoule per kilogram, then I will multiply by kilogram per second, the mass flow rate, is like this. 1 kilojoule per kilogram, okay, is equal to 1,000 meter squared per second squared. Okay, I need the value to be in kilojoule per kilogram, so I will divide by 1,000, okay? So I need to add here 1,000, okay? 1,000, this one is meter squared per second, and it will cancel with the unit of the V squared, okay? And at the top, it will be times 1, which is 1 kilojoule per kilogram. So yani, don't forget to divide by 1,000 because the answer will be wrong if you didn't divide, okay? So we will always divide by 1,000. So this is the equation, and خلاص we can put the numbers and solve for V2. Okay, so V2 at the end, you will have a value of 589.5 meter per second. That is the value for V2. Shift solve using the calculator. You have M dot H1, H2, you have everything. Okay, for part C, he asked for the area. Okay, and we said the area, the only equation that contains area is this one, okay? So for part C, I'll use this equation, okay? And rearrange it to calculate A2. Okay, so A2 will equal to M dot V2, the specific volume at state 2, over the velocity at 2. Velocity at 2, we calculated from a while here at the energy balance, 589.5 for a moment. Okay, and as you can see, this velocity is 589. V1 is only 60 meters per second. Okay, so there is a huge difference. M dot, I have it. V2, I already calculated from the energy balance. So what about the specific volume at state 2? Also, I needed to calculate V2 from the pressure P2 and T2. Okay, so also I will go to the table and take this value for V2 under the pressure 2 megapascal and 300 degrees Celsius. So V2 is 0.12551 meter cubed per kilogram. Okay, so I have also V2. So M dot was 4.0855 and V2 is 0.12551. Okay, and the velocity is 589.5. So the answer for A2 is equal to 8.7 times 10 to the negative 4 meter squared. Okay, and by this we finish the question 1 or 538. Okay, and as you can see, the area is very small compared to this one. This one is 50 meter squared times 10 to the negative 4. This one is 8.7. Okay, so if you have any questions about this problem, or we can continue to the other questions. Okay, جميل. Here in this question, we have refrigerant, so we'll use table A11 to A13, okay, and we have a compressor, okay. The compressor have the same shape like the nozzle, the previous question, but we will close this outlet and we close this inlet, and we have another inlet and another outlet here. From here we have inlet, okay, and from here we have outlet, okay, and the compressor is a consuming device, so it takes work input, okay. So we'll have a shaft, okay, that rotates, okay, and take a work input from other source, from electricity, from anything else, okay. So we have WNet or WN input, yani, okay, for the compressor. Always you have for the compressor WN, okay. So you will put it in the energy balance in the EN under A.N, okay. So we have at 180 kilopascal, okay, enters. So it's talking about the inlet of the compressor. So this one at P1 is equal to 180 kilopascal, okay. As a saturated vapor, so saturated vapor means that X is equal to 1, X1, alias state 1, equal to 1, okay, and you will use anything that HG, UG, VG, like this from the table, okay, with a flow rate, so a flow rate, which one, mass flow rate or volume flow rate, depends on the unit. The unit is in meter cubed, so he is talking about volume flow rate, okay, so the volume flow rate, V dot, is equal to 0.35 meter cubed per minute, okay. Usually we don't deal with minutes, so I will multiply by 1 minute over 60 seconds, okay, and this will give you 5.83 times 10 to the power negative 3 meter cubed per second, okay. The power supplied, so he said supplied, and we already know that the compressor is it's taking energy, so supplied, he is talking about power, so it is W dot N to the compressor or the refrigerant inside the compressor, it is equal to 2.35 kilowatt, okay. The turbine is work producing device, it produce work out, so if we see the equation or the question about the turbine, it will be work out instead of work in, but here we have compressor, okay. What is the temperature of R134 at the exit, okay, so he's talking about the exit, T2 at the exit. We missed this value for and leaves at 700 kilopascal, so also at B2 is equal to 700 kilopascal, okay. So I need to calculate the temperature, okay, the temperature of course from the table, because we don't have equations that contain temperature, so the only choice is to find the temperature from the table, okay, from the table A11 to A13, because we have refrigerant, okay. In order to find the temperature, I need properties from the table, so I can find the corresponding temperature, T2. But here at state 2, I only have the pressure, P2, so I need to find other property at state 2 in order to know T2, okay. In the equations, we said we have only two equations, one of them is M dot, okay, V, the velocity times area over the specific volume, okay, so either I have a specific volume or from the energy balance, and we said in the energy balance we have enthalpies, okay, so either I find H2 or I find V2, okay, you need one of these two properties, so you can use it with the pressure in order to find the temperature, okay. So let's do energy balance, okay, energy balance. So we have the inlet, of course you will have mass flow rate times the enthalpy, okay, and we have also a work consuming device, which is compressor, so we have work in, so I have W dot N, okay, nothing mentioned about the velocities or the height or the elevation, so there is no potential energy or kinetic energy, okay, so we don't have anything else in the N, okay. For out, we only have also M dot H2, okay, so what I am aiming for is to calculate H2, okay, because I need to calculate H2, then I can use it with the pressure, okay. So W dot N, let's move everything that contains, or all the terms that contains the mass rate in one side, so it will be M dot H2 minus H1, Now I need to calculate H1, and I need to calculate the mass flow rate, and I need to calculate H2, okay? Of course, I cannot use V2 with the pressure to collect T2 because I don't have area, okay? Already, I don't have A2, okay? And V2, it's not mentioned in the question, okay? So we ignored all of this. We neglect the velocity and area is not given. So I cannot use V2. That is why I'm looking for H2, okay? To use it with the pressure, okay? But here also, I don't have the mass flow rate, okay? How can I find the mass flow rate? The mass flow rate, what is given in the question is the volume flow rate. And we said at the beginning that the mass flow rate is the volume flow rate over the specific volume, okay? So I will use the mass flow rate. I will find the mass flow rate from the equation that the volume flow rate, which is given over the specific volume. Okay, and we know that m dot 1 is equal to m dot 2 and it is equal to m dot in general. So I will use the subscript v dot 1, which is at the inlet. He said with a flow rate 0.35 meter cubed, and he was talking about the entrance of the compressor. So he's talking this one is v dot 1. Okay, so v dot 1 over v1. In order to calculate the specific volume v1, I need two properties which already given. I have two information, which is v1, and I also have the saturated vapor. It is saturated vapor at state 1. So I will go to table A12 because it is refrigerant. Okay, so at table A12. Which with the pressure 180 kilopascal at table A12, the pressure table for the refrigerant. So 180 is this this line, okay? And I need to calculate VG. Why VG? Because he said saturated vapor x equal to 1, so anything at G, gas, okay? So VG is 0.011041, okay? So I will divide the volume flow rate, which is 5.83 times 10 to the power negative 3 over 0.11041, and this will give you 0.0528 kilogram per second, okay? Now I have the mass flow rate, and also I need to calculate H1 for any, also at the same pressure, and it is equal to HG. So I will take this value, HG, 242.86 kilojoule per kilogram. So I have also H1 equal to HG, and it is equal to 242.86 kilojoule per kilogram. Okay, and already given in the question W dot N. Right, W dot N is 2.35 kilowatts. So I have everything, so I can calculate H2. Okay, so let's calculate H2 from I will put the numbers in the equation. So it will be 2.35 equal to the mass flow rate 0.0528 H2 minus H1 242.86, and by the calculator you will find that H2 is equal to 287.37 kilojoule per kilogram. Okay, I found H2. Now I can use this value H2 with the pressure B2. Okay, in order to find the temperature T2, okay? I know that the pressure B2 given in the question 700 kilopascal, okay? And H2 is 287.37. Now let's check, okay? Compare my H2 with HG and HF and check if it is saturated mixture or superheated or what, okay? So at pressure 700 kilopascal, okay? So table A12, 700 kilopascal. This value is for HG, it is 265.03. My enthalpy is H2 is 287, so it is higher, okay? So H2 is higher than HG, okay? That means that the state 2 is superheated state, so I need to go to table A13, the superheated table. 700 kilopascal means 0.7 megapascal, okay? So and under this pressure, 0.7 megapascal. And my enthalpy is 287, okay? So 287 is between these two values, okay? And you need to do interpolation with the temperature. And you need to do interpolation with 40 and 50, and you find the temperature in between 40 and 50 with these values for the enthalpies, okay? So after the interpolation, you will find that the temperature, okay, I already sent the full solution. The temperature T2 is equal to 48.9 degree Celsius. Okay, so that is for the compressor. Okay, if you have any question about this problem, still we have half time for the other questions, inshallah. It seems there is no questions, so let's move on. Okay, is there any other way to solve? I don't think so, because you don't have the area, okay, and you don't have the area. You cannot use V2, okay, you cannot find V2. I mean, that is the only way, I think. Okay, if you find any other way, just tell me, and you'll solve it again, inshallah. Okay, so let's continue. Here we have this time air. So we took a question about steam, refrigerant, now we have air, okay? Air is a gas, and we assume it as ideal gas under certain conditions. Yani, we don't care about this. Under high temperature, more than the critical temperature, and low pressure, yani, there is assumptions. Okay, at the end, we assume it is ideal gas, okay? And you have two ways to solve questions that contains air as the working fluid, okay? Either you use constant specific heat assumption, constant specific heat assumption, heat assumption, okay? Or you have variable specific heat assumption, okay? Variable specific heat assumption. Okay, what is the difference between these two assumptions? It is assumption, so you can use any of these two assumptions, okay? And at the end, you will find the answer will be similar, okay? Yani approximately, it will be the same. Okay, here we use any equations that contain CB, CV, or K. Here we will use for air, table A17, okay? The solution manual solved this question using variable specific heat. I will solve it with constant specific heat. So you can have both solutions with both assumptions, okay? And we'll have another question, inshallah, if we have time. I will solve it with very specific heat, and the solution manual will already solve it with constant specific heat. So here, I will assume it is constant specific heat assumption, okay? So I will ignore the very specific heat assumption. I will assume it is constant specific heat assumption, okay? And you'll see that I will use CB because it is related to delta H. Delta H, the specific enthalpy is equal to CB delta T, okay? So I will use this equation. If I use very specific heat, I will say that I have temperature, and I will go to find the enthalpy H1, and I have the temperature 2, and I will find enthalpy H2. That is the variable specific heat from table A17. But we will see, inshallah. Okay? Now we will assume this constant specific heat assumption. Okay? Let's see. At 80 kilopascal, so I have 80 kilopascal, 27 degrees Celsius. Okay, what is the device? The device is the diffuser. Okay? The diffuser, okay? It is the opposite of the nozzle. The nozzle was like this, okay? The diffuser, okay? Now it's like this. There is increasing in the area, the cross-sectional area, okay? So we have air, and it is at 80 kilopascal, so B1 is equal to 80 kilopascal, okay? T1 is 27 degrees Celsius, and V1 is equal to 220 meters per second. Enters a diffuser at a rate, okay? So we have the rate, a kilogram per second, so yani m dot, okay? M dot is 2.5 kilogram per second. And leaves at 42 degrees Celsius, so T2 is equal to 42 degrees Celsius. The exit area, so A2, okay, of the diffuser is 400 times 10 to the power negative 4 meter squared. The air is estimated to lose heat, so we have also heat out, Q dot out, because he said rate, okay, so Q dot out equal to 18 kilojoule per second. During this process, determine the exit velocity, so V2, we need to calculate V2 at part A, okay, part A, and the exit pressure, also B2, okay, at part A. Okay, we said that the velocity, I can calculate the velocity with two ways, okay? Either I use the equation that m dot of this for V2, so it will be A2 V2 over specific volume 2, or I can use the energy balance equation, okay? Okay, now I don't have V2, I don't have, if I want to use this equation, I already have the mass flow rate. I have A2, the exit area. If I want to calculate V2, I need to calculate the specific volume, V2 small, the specific volume, but I don't have another property is more than the temperature. I only have one property at state 2, so I cannot use this equation. I need to find the pressure at state 2. So the only solution for me to calculate V2 is to use the energy balance. Okay, so we'll use the energy balance. Okay, E dot in equal to E dot out. Of course, we will have M dot H1, and on the other side, we'll have M dot H2. We have Q dot out. So we have Q dot out. He mentioned velocities, or usually we have velocities in diffusion and nozzles. Okay, so we have velocity one and we need to calculate V2. Okay, so it will be M dot V1 squared over two. And here on the other side, we will have M dot, okay, V2 squared over two. Okay, so I need to calculate V2. Okay, I have the mass flow rate given in the question. Okay, I have the velocity given in the question. I have Q out given in the question. The remaining is what? H1 and H2. Okay, and I said I want to use the constant specific heat assumption, which we use any equation that contains CV, CV, okay? Here for delta H, C, it is equal to CV delta T. So I need to arrange the equation to put H2 and H1 together, okay? So in order to replace delta H with CV delta T, okay? So I will arrange this equation, and usually arrange it that we put all the terms that contain mass rate on one side, okay? So it will be like this, M dot H1 minus H2 plus V1 squared minus V2 squared, and we said we will divide by 1,000 in order to convert the units from meter squared over second squared to kilojoule per kilogram for the velocities. So I will multiply by 1,000, and it is equal to Q dot out. Okay, now I will replace H1 and H2 by CB delta T. Okay, so it's CB T1 minus T2. Okay, the delta, like the itself, you start with one, you write temperature T1 first. Okay. So V1 squared minus V2 squared over 2,000, okay, will equal to Q dot out. Okay, I have everything, but except that I need to find CB. CB, this one is the average, okay, CB average. Okay, so we will find it at T average, okay, which is T1 plus T2, okay, over 2. And you have the temperature, both 27 and 42. Over 2, and this will give you that the temperature is 34.5 degrees Celsius, and you will find CB average from table A to B. So if you go to table A to B, okay, A to B, this one, you will have under the air, we have the air as our gas, okay? You have different values for CB, CV, and K corresponding to different values of temperature, but in Kelvin, okay? So you need to convert this value, the T average, to be in Kelvin, and it is 307.5 in Kelvin. And then you need to do interpolation, because you don't have 307, you will do interpolation with 300 and 350 to calculate CV, and as you can see, it will not make a huge difference in the value for CV. Okay, at the end, after interpolation, CB will equal to 1.00545 kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin. Okay, so I have CB. Khalas, I have the temperature, I have the velocities, I have the. I need to calculate V2. Okay, I only have V1. I have Q dot out. I have everything. I will put the numbers in the equation. Okay, and at the end with the calculator, I will find that the V2 is equal to 61.94 meter per second. Okay, so I calculated V2. Now, the other requirement or part B in the question, he asked for the pressure, B2, okay? So B2, it is air, and we calculate, as I said at the beginning of the tutorial, we calculate the pressure for the gas using the ideal gas law, which is B2 equal to RT2 over V2, okay? I have T2, R from the tables, either you find it from table A2 here, 0.287, or table A1, also 0.287, R kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin. So I have R from the table, T2 given in the question 42, but I have to put it in Kelvin, so I need to convert it to V in Kelvin at 273. The remaining is to find V2, okay? V2, the only choice for me to find V2 is to use the tables, okay? Is to use, not the table, here is, we have gas, so of course I will use the equation. The V2 is only contained in this equation, the mass flow rate equal to A2 V2 over V2, okay? So I will arrange this equation, so it will be equal to V2 equal to A2 V2 over M dot. Okay, I have M dot given in the question. A2 also given in the question, 400 times 10 to the power negative 4. If you don't use the area given in the question in this equation, then there is something wrong in your solution, okay? V2, already we calculated V2 from the energy balance, so I can find V2 easily. Okay, the area is 410 to times 10 to the power negative 4. V2 is from the energy balance is 61.94. And the mass flow rate given in the question, 2.5, okay? So V2 will give you the answer will be 0.991 meter cubed per kilogram. Now I have V2, I can use it in the equation for the pressure. So R is 0.287. I have to put the temperature in Kelvin. It will be 442 plus 273. And you will divide by V2, it is 0.991. And at the end, you'll find the pressure B2 is equal to 91.23 kilopascal. Okay, so that is the solution for this question about diffuser. Okay, if you have any problem with this question, you can ask. I can see the chat while I'm explaining and or while I'm solving, so you can ask Yanni during my explanation. Okay, so there is no questions. So let's see a question about turbine. Okay, so he said adiabatic. The word adiabatic means there is no heat transfer, Q dot equal to zero. So the word adiabatic means Q dot equal to zero, okay? A gas turbine. So he said gas, so I expect that he will mention a gas, which is air, okay? Turbine, okay, we have turbine. The turbine, it is similar to the drawing for the diffuser, okay? But we will close the outlet and we'll close the inlet. And we will put another inlet from here, okay? And outlet from here, okay? So the fluid is moving from here and is going out from this side, okay? The turbine is work producing device. It is opposite to the compressor. So you'll have a shaft work here, okay? And it is will produce work out. So the turbine is work producing device. So we'll have W dot out, okay? Okay, let's see the question. Expands air at, expands means that the pressure will decrease. And the purpose of the turbine is to decrease the pressure. It will be, it was 1,300, it will be 100 kilopascal. For the compressor, it is opposite, okay? The compressor increases the pressure. That is the purpose of the compressor, okay? Here I have turbine, so air at 1,300 kilopascal, so at the inlet, okay? B1 is equal to 1,300 kilopascal. Okay, and T1 is equal to 500 degrees Celsius. Okay, and at state 2, B2 is equal to 100 kilopascal. And T2 is equal to 127 degrees Celsius. Okay, air, so we have air, and we said we'll assume it is ideal gas, so we can use the ideal gas equations. Okay, ideal gas. And in this question, I will assume I will use the assumption, the variable specific heat assumption, variable specific heat assumption. You can assume it is constant heat assumption like the previous question, and you substitute instead of delta HCB, delta T, but here I will assume it is variable specific heat. The solution manual used the constant specific heat. Okay, so we will have variable specific heat assumption, okay. I will use, okay? Enter the turbine through a 0.2 meter squared. So the inlet area, A1, is equal to 0.2 meter squared, okay? Opening with an average velocity. So I have V1 is equal to 40 meter per second. And exhaust through a 1 meter squared opening. So the yani, exhaust mean the outlet, okay? So A2 is equal to 1 meter one meter squared. Okay, determine the mass flow rate. So at part A, determine the mass flow rate, and we know that M dot one equal to M dot two, and at the end it's equal to M dot. So it is the mass flow rate through the turbine. So I need to calculate the mass flow rate. Okay, and the power produced by the turbine. So W dot out, it is producing device, work producing device. The turbine produce work. So W dot out, of course, W dot out, we know from the energy balance. Okay, here for the mass flow rate, of course, if he asked about the work W out, okay, it means it is not known for me. I cannot use the energy balance to calculate mass flow rate because already the energy balance will have also another unknown, which is the work out. So of course, the mass flow rate, I need to use it to calculate the mass flow rate using the equation AV over the specific volume, okay? Of course, I don't have here, it is not mentioned that I have the velocity, okay, at state 2, okay? So I cannot use subscript 2, okay? So I cannot use subscript 2. So I need to use the subscript 1, okay? A1, V1 over V1, the specific volume 1. Because I already have A1 and already have V1, I have two things, okay? So how can I calculate V1 in order to calculate M dot? The specific volume, and we have gas, air, okay? So you know that for air, we assume it is idle gas, so I can use the equation for the idle gas law, which is equal to B1, V1 equal to R, T1. So I can use the equation V1 is equal to R, T1 over B1. R, we said from the table, 0.287 kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin. T1 given in the question, but I have to put it in Kelvin. B1 also given. Okay, so خلاص, I can calculate V1. R is 0.287. Okay, T1, 500 degree plus 273. B1 is 1,300 kilopascal. So V1 at the end will be equal to 0.1707 meter cubed per kilogram. Now I can use this value to put it here. Okay, I have everything, the area, the velocity, and the specific volume. I can find part A, which is the mass flow rate. So the mass flow rate is equal to 0.2 times 40 over 0.1707. And this will give you 46.87 kilojoule per second. This value is for the mass flow rate using the variable specific heat assumption. Look here, he put the answers and he used constant state heat assumption. The value for the mass flow rate is 46.9. So it is very close to the variable state heat assumption. So at the end, they will give you approximately the same answer. Okay. What about part B? Okay, of course, we'll use the energy balance to calculate the work out. So I will say A dot N equal to A dot out. Okay. At the inlet, of course, I will have M dot H1. And at the outlet, of course, I will have M dot H2. And it is a turbine, so it is work producing device. So I put the work in the out, so W dot out. Okay. I have velocities. Okay. He didn't give me the velocity at state 2, but I have velocity at state 1. So I cannot neglect velocity at state 2 also. And I have to put both. Okay. So V1 and V2. So I have also here M dot V1 squared over 2. And I also have here M dot V2 squared over 2. Okay. Now I want to calculate the work W out, so I will put it in one side. I will move other terms that contains the mass rate to the other side. So it will be equal to M dot H1 minus H2 plus V1 squared minus V2 squared. And we said we'll divide by 2000, okay, 2 times 1000, okay. Here I have the mass rate I calculated from part A. I have velocity V1, but I don't have V2. So V2 is missing, H1 and H2 is missing also. So I need to calculate H1, H2, V2 in order to calculate W dot out, okay? Here I said it is a variable specific heat assumption. In the previous question, we assumed it's constant specific heat assumption. So I replace H2 by CB, delta T, okay? Here, this you cannot use this equation if you assume this variable specific heat. Oh yeah, of course, I will give you a right answer if you assume it's constant, okay? But here we'll assume it is variable. Assume the doctor said variable specific heat in the question. Okay, what you need to do is to use table A17, okay? The beautiful thing about table A17 that if you know one property, you can know any other property corresponding to this property that you already know. Okay, so at state 1 and state 2, I have the temperature T1 and I have the temperature T2. If you saw the table A17, it's like this, table A17. For air, you have temperature, you have enthalpy, You have relative pressure, relative volume. This is related to other things, and you will not use it. And you have U and S naught. Okay, now we care about enthalpy. Okay, so we'll use the first two columns. Okay, I have the temperature, خلاص, the corresponding value for the enthalpy. Okay, so that is what I will do. So now I have T1, okay, T1. And the question is 500 degrees Celsius, which is in Kelvin, 773 Kelvin, because table A17 is in Kelvin, okay? It is in Kelvin. Okay, I want to find the corresponding value H1 from the table. Okay, of course, we will not find 773. Okay, it is something here, 773. It is between 760, 780. And this value is for enthalpy, so you need to do interpolation, okay? After you do interpolation, you will have the answer for H1. It will be equal to 792.383 kilojoule per kilogram. Okay. And for T2 given in the question, it is 400 Kelvin in Kelvin, but in Celsius, it is 127. So in Kelvin, it is 400 Kelvin. Okay. You will go to the table. And 400 is, you will find the values for the enthalpy corresponding to 400. So 400 Kelvin, the value of enthalpy corresponding to the 400 Kelvin is 400.98. So H2 is 400.98 kilojoule per kilogram. Okay, so now we calculate H1, you calculate H2. The remaining is to calculate the velocity. Okay, if I didn't find the velocity from here, okay, because there is also another unknown, which is W dot out, which I want to find. So the only solution is to calculate V2 from the other equation, which is M dot equal to A2 V2 over the specific volume 2. Okay. Okay, now in the question, I am given I calculated the mass flow rate. So let's arrange the equation in order to calculate. Okay, but I don't have V2. So also the missing is to calculate V2. So V2, it is ideal gas, it is air. So I can use the equation V2 is equal to B2 T2 this R2, R in general, T2 over B2, okay? I have the temperature, I have the pressure given in the question and R from the table, okay? R from the table, I have the pressure, I have the temperature. I can calculate V2 and for the area, do I have the area for this question? I have the area or no? V2, I have what I calculated in the first part is the mass flow rate, right? Okay, and did he give me the area, the exit? Yes, okay, and now I have the area. Okay, so I have the area. Okay, I have the area. I have the specific volume. I already calculated mass flow rate from A. So the remaining is V2. I can calculate it from here. Okay, so let's first find V2, the specific volume. So it is equal to R T2 over B2, R 0.287 from table A1 or A2A. Okay, times the temperature must be in Kelvin. It is 100, of course, T2, 127 plus 273. Okay, over 100. The pressure at state 2, so the specific volume will equal to 1.148 meter cubed per kilogram. I have the specific volume, I have the area given, mass flow rate from part A. I can rearrange the equation and find V2, the velocity at state 2. So V2 will equal to m dot V2 over A2. M dot, we calculate m dot to be 46.87 kilogram per second. So 46.87 times V2, this small V2 specific volume, 1.148, and the area is 1 meter squared. So V2 will equal to 53.81 meter per second. Now I found the velocity at state 2. I already calculated the enthalpies, so I have everything. Okay, now I can put the numbers in the equation and I can calculate W dot out. If you use the calculator and this equation, the energy balance, W dot out will be equal to 18.315 megawatt using variable specific heat. As you can see, with constant specific heat, he got 18.3. So it is approximately the same. Okay, we have 6 minutes, inshallah, and we have one question left. So let's go to the final question. Okay, we have refrigerant again, so table A11 to A13 is throttled from a saturated liquid. When he said throttled means throttling valve, expansion valve, he maybe say capillary tube. Okay, this device is, the purpose of this device is to decrease the pressure. Okay, at the beginning it was 700 kilopascal and then it was 160 kilopascal. Okay, if you do energy balance on the throttling valve, E dot N equal to E dot out, you don't have any work, you don't have heat emission, any heat transfer, and usually you will not have any heat transfer because usually it is very small device and there is no chance that the heat transfer will take place inside the throttling valve. So usually it will be ignored, okay? And you will not have any, they will neglect also the velocity, the elevation. So at the end, you will have m dot h1 equal to m dot h2. And of course, m dot means it is m dot equal to m dot 2, and in general, it is m dot. So m dot will cancel with m dot. The beautiful thing about throttling valve, it is easy, and you know the information that h1 is equal to h2, okay? Determine the temperature. What that drop? So he asked about the temperature drop. Drop means there is change. It was something, then it was another temperature, okay? So delta T, he is asking about delta T, which is T2 minus T1, okay? That is the first thing. And also he is asking about the final specific volume. So V small 2, okay, is the specific volume at state 2, okay? In order to calculate the temperatures from the table, because it is refrigerant, okay? In order to calculate the temperature, I need two properties. I need two information. At state 1, I have the pressure and have saturated liquid, okay? But I don't have, at state 2, two properties. I only have the pressure, okay? So I need other property. In order to know what is the other property, I know this throttling valve, and if I did energy balance, I know that H1 is equal to H2. So I can calculate H1 also from here, from state 1. Then I say that H2 is equal to H1, and now I will have two properties at state 2. I can find the temperature T2 from here, and I can find the temperature T1 from here, and I will finish the first part or the first requirement, which is the change in temperature delta T, okay? The remaining is V2. V2, we need to calculate it after we find enthalpy H2. Let's see how we'll solve this question, okay? So, I have the pressure B1 is equal to 700 kilopascal given in the question. And I know the information that it is saturated liquid, so I use anything with the subscript F for fluid, yani, in order to calculate T1. And already saturated liquid means what? Yani, means it is in the saturated mixer region. So if I draw the BV diagram or the TS diagram, TV diagram, it's better, okay? Okay, TV diagram, and I have the pressure 700 kilopascal. It is like this. No, the pressure this one will be increasing. Okay, it will be something like this. Okay, the pressure is equal to 700 kilopascal. Okay, saturated liquid means at this state, this point, okay, as a saturated liquid line, means the temperature is the saturation temperature. Okay, so directly from the table, I will go at the pressure 700 kilopascal table A12 for refrigerant, and I will say that T1 is equal to Tset. Okay, because it is a saturated liquid, so it is in the saturation region. Okay, so T1 equal to Tset at the pressure 700 kilopascal from table A12, the pressure table for refrigerant, so 700 kilopascal, Tset is equal to 26.69. Okay, so 26.69 degree Celsius. And also I need to calculate H1 in order to calculate H2, okay, because I know H1 is equal to H2, okay, so H1 will be equal to HF, right? Okay, at 700 kilopascal. So H1 equal to HF, which one? This one, 88.82. Okay, kilojoule per kilogram. Now I will use the information that H1 is equal to H2 with the pressure B2 is equal to 160 kilopascal, and H2 is equal to H1, which is 88.82. And I will go to the table at 160 kilopascal, table A12, 160 kilopascal here. Okay, and compare my enthalpy with the HG and HF. As you can see, HG is 241 and HF is 31.21. So my H is between HF and HG. So it is saturated mixture, okay? When it is saturated mixture also, that means what? That means that T2 is equal to T sat, okay? So equal to T sat, which is negative 15.6. The tutorial has finished. Okay, if you subtract negative 15.6 from 26.69, you will find delta T. And for the specific volume, you know that it is a saturated mixture. When you want to calculate any property at saturated mixture, what you need is to calculate it using the equations that contain quality. So Vf plus X, Vg minus Vf. Okay, you have Vg and Vf from at the pressure 160 kilopascal. The remaining is that you calculate X2, okay, at state 2. And you can calculate X2 easily using that you already have H2 and you have HF, HFG at 160 kilopascal. So X2 will equal to H2 minus HF over HFG. And by this, you can calculate V. Okay, so we finished the all the questions, alhamdulillah. So, if you have any questions, you can ask. If you don't have, we can finish that tutorial, inshallah. You are most welcome. Okay, if you don't have any questions, inshallah, let's see you in the next tutorial, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum. Thank you. Thank you very much. Stop the recording.